Good afternoon, Falls Church. This morning I wanted to go over a little bit of dot loop training with you and show you how to set up your first loop. So once you log in your EH control panel or access dot loop through dotloop.com, I want you to come here and click on Start Transactions. Once you've entered into your loop, you should notice that your screen is black and red and white. If you happen to log in and it is blue and white, please contact David Donaldson immediately, because you're not currently linked to the KW Falls Church Market Center. In order to go ahead and coordinate your first loop, your screen may look like this. This is what we call loop view. I prefer to switch to list view, and you can do that by clicking right here. Once you've switched to list view, you click over here to your right hand side where it says create a loop. Now it's very important when you name a loop that you name it after the property address. However, if you're working with a buyer and you have yet to identify a property for purchase, go ahead and utilize the buyer's last name and we can change it to the property address at a later time. As you notice, when I started typing in the property address, we see a list of properties that come up from around the country. Well, dot loop is international, so you will not just see local listings here, but if you continue to type into the property bar, you will see your local listing that you may be looking for. So in this particular case, let's go ahead and sell the office. So you can see here currently that I actually have the office listed for sale. Don't really, but it's an example. You can see that it says dot loop with MLS number offered by myself. If the listing is not currently for sale in the MLS and you keep typing a property, you will not see an MLS number or a listing as you do down here. You'll see that it's sourced by Google Maps. When you're taking a listing, this will be the case. Not all listings are showcased in dot loop because not all listings are entered into dot loop. It is not currently connected to the MRS or tax records. So it will only see a listing by agent or an MLS number if that property is currently what we call searchable inside a dot loop. So go ahead and grab this property just like this. The next thing you will need to do is select the template. At the moment, we have all of our listings for Virginia, sales for Virginia, lease Virginia in here. And as you can see, DC is coming along. We will continue to add loop templates from Maryland and DC once we get all the documentation available for you. So go ahead and select a VA listing and then go ahead and create your loop. Congratulations, you've just created your first loop. And as you'll see, all the standard documents that you would use in a typical transaction are in the Listing Docs for Compliance folder. There is the Offer folder. Once you receive an offer on a property, that you will manually match these up here. And then you have Miscellaneous folder for the documents that don't need to be submitted to the Market Center, but you accumulate and like to keep in your files. You'll see that the people are incorporated into the loop, admin, the broker, and in this case, me, which would be yourself, and any tasks if you've created a task list to go along. Some of these things we will add in our future conversations about how to build those, but today we're just talking about launching your first loop. So come back more often for more training, and I'll see you then. Have a great day.